shambles.
Tell me about it.
I want me van unloaded today. Jimmy's gear. We should have taken him to Newcastle or wherever he was going, made sure he stayed there.
Yeah, let's just write it off to experience, eh?
You do without that sort of experience, thanks. He was carrying on like we were on a night out in Blackpool.
He gets like that.
Jimmy stuffed up everything. What's he got to say for himself this morning?
Come in. See for yourself.
So, what did you do? Mug the Easter Bunny?
I swear, we didn't touch a hair on his head.
Get it?
Ah! The third musketeer. All right, Steve, what a note!
The three of you went?
Yeah, Jimmy sort of tagged along.
Yeah, Steve, grab yourself a piece of chocolate here. Fantastic!
So, what did you get up to?
Well, not much as it turned out.
Oh, you should have been there then.
Sounds like he's at the time of his life.
Yeah, well, things didn't go according to plan.
Yes and no. Probably better I was there.
You must be joking.
What plan? Didn't know you had one.
Neither did I. I mean, call it luck, chance, whatever you like. I was there!
No doubt about that.
So, when did this job come up?
Well, it didn't, kind of. It was one of those chance things, wasn't it, Jim?
The great chocolate heist, eh?
Yeah. It's not exactly what we expected, was it?
Oh, you're not still banging on about those leathers, are you?
Leathers? You went after my mate's fella?
No.
You're lying. Steve?
I don't know who he was.
Oh, you said you'd followed him.
Oh, well, maybe Jimmy could tell me the truth then, eh?
There's nothing to tell him. Look, it all went wrong. No harm done, eh?
Did he see you? Would you recognise us again?
Well, me and Tim are in the clear. Can't say the same for Bob the Builder there.
He took a digger for a bit of a joyride.
And we could have sold that digger and all.
Oh, I've got to go. We'll talk about this later.
I had a lifetime to talk to me, Mum. But I don't think I ever told her what I was really like. I was frightened to talk to her, you know, even at this age.
Did she know that you had a daughter? She was a grandmother.
Well, I was thinking of telling her last week, but no. I probably wouldn't have.
Don't have too many regrets, Ray. Make the most of what you got now.
Done! A full account, every last detail.
You can't write it down.
Well, I didn't think I could either, but there it is. 924 words and not one of them an embellishment.
Tell me you haven't put it on your website.
There's a thought.
Don't even think about it.
You want a clean out?
I'm having a throw out. I've got prospective buyers coming along later, so I thought I'd best make the place look half decent. And sitting upstairs in the flat doing nothing is so depressing.
Help yourself.
Oh, no, I was just curious.
Hey, you know what students are like, always scrounging.
Hey, you've lost everything, and I know the feeling. Look, it's only bar towels and T-shirts, only at the charity shop.
Well, in that case. Egg, collector's item is these.
They might have a certain nostalgic value in a few months' time.
Look, Bev, this might be insulting, but, well, it was on the notice board in the uni. I'm going to apply, so maybe you should.
Waitress and jobs?
Yeah. Hey, we'd have a lot together, you know we would. You always made it great fun working in there. Look, I'll leave it with you anyway. Thanks for my T-shirt.
Yeah, well, thanks for working for nothing.
See you, Bev.
Bye.
What are you doing?
Up the neck.
Where's my file? My essay on last night, I saved it. Night vision, dot, doc. Nearly 1,000 words, where is it?
Dunno.
Never mind, you don't know. It must be here somewhere. I spent all morning on it. What have you done with it?
I haven't touched it.
I did write it, I know I did. Maybe I didn't. I was there, wasn't I? Last night, I didn't make it up to that. My feelings are real.
Yeah, they are real, Jimmy.
Yeah, well, never mind. It's all up here. Nobody can take that away from me. I lived it. You can't beat that.
Yeah, you can't. Listen, Jimmy. I hope you don't mind me asking, but where do you think you're at? On your scale, you know?
I'm not sure. Four.
A four?
A four or five!
You know, before when you were talking about the insurance paying the rent until the house is rebuilt?
Yeah, I'm sorry, I completely forgot.
Oh, no, no, not to worry.
What was my mum's death and everything, you know?
Well, that's totally understandable. Has it come through yet?
Hasn't it shown up on the account?
No. It's gone straight into an account.
Well, it should have done. We'll have to check with Max.
Max?
Yeah.
He's looking after Ron's business while Jackie's away.
He's sorting everything out for us, you know.
What Max has?
Mm. The money's being backdated and paid directly into Ron's account.
Right. Good.
I don't think you should be in the house. We've got big problems.
Oh, nothing that a divorce won't solve. I did not tell you about Dougie so you could go and rip him off.
No, I'm sorry.
What was you thinking about him? If Natalie makes that connection, then I am dead meat.
He won't.
You use me.
You've got nothing to worry about.
Don't start trying to deny
it. I needed to help me decide what to do.
So they did see you?
No, about Willy Wonka. Look, I think he's gone into one of those manic fits he warned us about. Right, you know the bit of paper you wrote down telling us what to do? Where is it?
I don't know.
We've got to find it.
Well, isn't it on the computer?
No, don't switch that on again. It might make him worse.
Tim, I thought you read up on all this.
I know, but that was just reading. But this is serious. He hasn't got a clue how much danger he put us in last night.
Danger?
Yeah. He was acting like a total lunatic and he hasn't got a clue now.
He said if he goes like this, to lock him up so he doesn't hurt himself or us.
Oh, we can't do that.
He said...
Are you still here?
I've been to work and come back on me dinner.
Already? Oh, what? Done all of a few hours, have you? You're going to meet yourself coming back one of these days, do you know that? You don't know the meaning of graft. Been sticking a few curlers in, have you? Painting a few nails? Teaching? That was a job with meaning, purpose.
My job has got a purpose. It makes people feel good.
Oh, does it? Oh, does it now? What do you are? You know, make me feel good. Go on. Make me feel good.
I think we should get the doctor.
A doctor? Oh, all right. Been talking about me, have you?
Jimmy, you told us to look out for you.
Oh, your professional opinion as a hairdresser is that I need a doctor. Is that right?
No. No, look, we just all worked up about last night. Why don't you just go and have a little bit of a sleep, Jimmy?
Who can sleep?
Well, what about that bath that you talked about, eh? Have you got any new clothes in your room?
I don't know. I'd have.
Well, why don't you go and get them then, eh? And, you're going to run on bath, won't you?
Yeah.
That's it. You have a nice bath. Go on, Jim. Get your clothes. I'm sorry, Jim! But you said it's for your own safety! I'm sorry!
This is my house! This is my house!
Still got your lodgers from the fire?
Yeah. What brings you here?
A favour.
Come in.
Well,
It's nice, isn't it?
Not quite my taste. Hey, where exactly did Clint cop it?
You okay, Jimmy?
You're as bad as a screw!
It's what we promised you we'd do!
So leave me alone! Leave me in here to rot!
This doesn't seem right.
No!
Jim?
I'm hurt!
Badly?
Really bad. Let me out.
He said he'd probably try it on.
Come on!
You said to ignore you, Jim.
I was lying!
This stinks. What were you meant to leave him in there for?
I don't know. Until he's okay, I guess.
How are we supposed to know when that is? I'm gonna go and make him some food. You get him a jug of water, and make it a plastic jug.
Hey, Tim, don't think you got away with all this lying, neither. I might have to quit my course now because of your stupidity.
I thought you were giving me a genuine tip-off.
When did I say that? When did I say anything like that?
I could be dying in here for all you care. I'm not giving in. I am not giving in.
Hiya. Hey, you went round a cheese and ham. He's to add a row.
Who's there? Let me out.
Jimmy.
Leave him, Nick. What's going on? It's what he wants.
Please let me out.
Jimmy, it's okay. It's me, Nicky. What's happening?
Nick, they tricked me. They tricked me. They played the joke.
No, Nick. You're starting to lose a big style. We made the deal when we first moved in. And he said the best thing to do was, if he ever got like this, to shut him up in case he ended up on the roof or anything.
That's barbaric. He needs professional help.
Oh, very fetching.
Bev wants you to pick Josh up from school. Mind you, I could do it if you want to get more sleep.
No, I'll do it. Is that me lunch?
Yeah.
Oh, hell. No, I'll do it. I dropped it. Such a waste.
It doesn't matter.
Oh, and we can really afford to be chucking food around the kitchen, can't we?
Don't take that tone with me.
I think it's time for me to go. You won't forget about Josh, will you?
Unlikely.
I let myself out.
Oh, I'm sorry, Reg. But you'll never guess what our ever-so-helpful brother-in-law did.
What?
He's hijacked our rent from Ray and Jesse.
How?
He's organised for it to be paid into my dad's bank account.
Oh.
Oh, is that all you can say? Because we were counting on that money, Rachel. The week's debt they owe us, plus £100 a week from now on.
We were wrong to think that money should come to us. Of course it should go to your dad.
Oh, well, I'm glad you think like that, because you're going to have a really nice birthday now, aren't you?
Yeah, well, why don't we just cancel all birthdays and Christmas from now on, then? We can't rely on other people's misfortune all the time. And why don't you concentrate on the things you have got for a change?
Like what?
Like a wife and a child who love you. Two children.
He just doesn't think of me as his dad.
Yeah, well, it's not up to him. Do you want to end up like Ray? And have Josh knocking on the door when he's 40 saying, "Hey, Dad, do you remember me?"
Look, Rachel, nothing has turned out the way I wanted it.
Oh, well, stop whinging about it then and change it. You can't keep waiting for someone to come and rescue you all the time. Take charge for once.
Ray, I never meant to deceive you over those shares.
I never meant to deceive you about Helen.
If I can help at Kiss's funeral, I'd like to.
Yeah, she's left some funds for that.
Yeah, I know. But if you'd like to make it a bit special.
I'd rather respect what she wanted. There's enough for that. I need to start organising it.
Jimmy! We've made you some food. Can I bring it in? All right, I'm just going to leave it on the side. Let me know when you want it.
You can't live your life inside four walls. Inside your head. You gotta be in it to win it. Stand up and be counted. Otherwise you're just another one of those if only people. If only you'd done this. If only you'd done that. That's not for me. Jimmy Corker lives and breathes. His experience is a first hand. Not something he's watched on the telly.
He wasn't right before he went to Newcastle. I did this useless exercise with him.
I've never done that.
As if one conversation with me is going to make any difference.
I have never told him.
I knew when he came back that he was still climbing.
Nick, it's not your fault.
Never taken a risk.
I should have talked him into going to see Dr. Parr then.
Never lied.
My whole essay questioned who takes responsibility for the mentally ill.
Yeah, and it's not you.
Well, why am I studying then? Somebody has to.
He even drove me wife into the arms of another woman.
The way he is.
It won't be long. Just don't let him out, okay?
Treat him like a caged animal.
Tim, what's so important?
Steve needs some stuff clean out of his van.
What stuff? Oh, can't it wait? Oh, that type of stuff.
Yeah.
You best go then.
I can't be 15 minutes, Max.
Know all about it, I've done the lot. And more.
Just try to ignore him.
I know what it feels like.
Oh, can I, Em? Listen to him. He's torturing himself.
Oh, what is it with you and him, eh? He's not your dad. He's just some owl fella that's not the full shilling.
He took you in when you had nowhere else to go. He's letting all of us live here.
Oh, only because he doesn't want to be on his own. And I reckon he's got the wrong idea about you and all. You need to be careful.
This is awful. I can't put him through it.
Nicky, no!
Jimmy, please move away from the door. I want to come in. Some food here for you. Let's have something to eat together. We're all really worried about you. I know I don't know much, but this isn't the answer. Come on, Jim. You wouldn't let a friend go through this alone. And we've become friends, haven't we? Couldn't have written that essay without your insight.
Oh, yeah.
Nicky, don't go in.
You're a brave girl. Didn't they tell you? You're not safe.
I'm frightened of you, Jim. See that? Needs dressing. Look, there's no shame asking for a bit of support, you know. But Tim, Emily, me, we're not the right people. And I know how you feel about doctors.
No, no, I'm not going there again.
No, well, you mightn't have to. Not if you get this under control, but sooner rather than later. You've got through before, Jim, and you can get through it again.
Have I? Have I? Oh, one pathetic little essay, and you think you know all about me, do you?
No, no, and that's what I'm saying.
Think you can talk me round?
Are you all right, Nick?
Yeah.
Tricky thing, the relationship between a man and a woman. We're supposed to fit, but we don't. Somebody got the characters all wrong. Sex. That's where it all falls apart. I mean, can a man and a woman, well, can a man and a young girl like yourself have a platonic relationship?
I
Simple question, Nicky.
I only want to help you.
Jackie didn't think so. I was having an affair, according to her. It was never sex I was after. We had that. What we lost was the affection. You know, the ability just to hold each other. That's what I miss. A cuddle can make all the difference. Will you cuddle me? See how nice that feels? Lindsay was always good for a cuddle. But then, there's cuddles. And there's cuddles. What about you and Jerome? Or is he only interested in the hot, sweaty stuff?
Jimmy, please!
I mean, nothing wrong with that. With the right person and the right pool table. What's wrong? I thought you wanted to get to know me. Can't keep a load of beauty products under my bed like a farm.
Yeah, and I can't take them next door. Jimmy and the state he's in.
Yeah, don't start.
All right. And now?
Hey, long time no see. What happened to you? You play with fire, sometimes you get burned.
Yeah.
Hard Adele reckon that Leanne would give you a warm welcome. Leanne? She'd soon know about it if she laid a finger on me, mate.
I'd like to go now, please, Jimmy.
Snap. That's what I've been saying.
You need to go and see the doctor.
Yep. I'll go and do that.
You will?
Or we could stay here. You and me. What sort of friends would you say we are? Right then. See ya.
Nicky, what's wrong?
So what do you want, anyway? Can I come say hello to my family? Leanne's got off to the soft tissue specialist. Adele said she got off early, so she'll be back soon.
Just seeing her anyway? Apart from the compo.
Well, you know where to find her. You're willing to try most things. And whatsoever.
I was trying to help him.
You helped him all right, didn't you? Right out of the house.
Max, I need to go back to work.
Would you mind very much if I came to the funeral tomorrow?
Keep on going on about our future. If I end up on some crappy little job, we haven't got a future.
My solicitor says I could be scarred for life.
Get out of my way, or you will be scarred for life.
Auntie, what's happened?
More Brookie Wednesday at 8. Now, find out more about manic depression and ask confidential questions by checking that address there, channel4.com/health.
Who are you phoning?
Lindsay. See if Jimmy's gone up there.
Do you think that's a good idea? No. I'm just saying. If he's not there, you'll just worry, won't you?
Where could he be, Em?
No. Maybe he's gone to Jackie's.
No. That's the last place he'd go.
Look, Nick, he's a grown man. You've got to stop putting tabs on him. You look knackered.
I am. Have you said anything? What do I have to do now? Last time we walk about, he ended up on the school roof, didn't he?
I know. And then there was someone there to talk him round. Who's he got now? No one.
Oh, what is it with you, eh? You're up to your eyeballs in debt and you're chewing your nails over Jimmy.
Yeah, well, maybe it's down to you two that he's out there in the first place.
What have I done?
Just one dodgy deal after another. Carrying on like a pair of scallies, doing anything to make it easy for you quid.
Oh, you were the one stupid enough to go into the room.
I was trying to help him.
Help him? You helped him all right, didn't you? Right out of the house. He wouldn't have run off if it weren't for you, Nicky. Looking down your nose at us. And whose fault was it that my nans and Ray's house was burnt down, eh?
That was an accident, and you know it. And don't you dare take the moral high ground with me. When you and him are getting fat off ripping other people off.
Talking about helping people, eh? All right, then. Well, I'll help. Take that money that Tim offered you.
You're only offering it me because you know I can't take it.
Prove me wrong, then. Put a bit of a dent in your overdraft, won't it?
I take that money, and it makes me as bad as you, doesn't it?
Jerome would. And she knows it. Come on. All she want to do is ask.
I wouldn't have it on my conscience.
At least it leaves us a grand better off, eh?
That money is staying where it is. Don't worry, she'll come round. And when she does, she won't be asking for it. She'll be begging.
Oh, 12 minutes, eh? Not bad for you, phone him.
Well, give me another 5. I'll see what I can do.
Yeah, like that's sort of welcome home.
It's good to have you back.
So, come on. What state's everything been in?
Oh, it's okay, really.
Jesse and Ray's rent's going straight into your father's account.
Oh, great.
Sammy Rogers behaving herself at the health club. Oh, and Sol reminded me that his contract's up for renewal, so... But that's your department. Apart from that, I think that's it, really. Oh, yes, I had to have a few words with Jessie. She let a client down. I had to explain to her that we can't afford to let that happen.
How did she take that?
Well, she took great pleasure in reminding me that she works for Mrs. Farnham, not Mr. Farnham. Not one of my proudest moments.
Do you know what? I thought you'd love all that, getting the whip out and disciplining the staff.
Well, you know, Jessie and Ray, the fire.
Max, it's my dad's business at stake. We're not running a charity. Anyway, come on. That's all the boarding stuff out the way. I want to know all the goss about Bev and Leanne. Mum?
It's all right, Steph. This is Ray. He's an old friend of me, Auntie Sylvia's. See ya. You gonna stand there all day?
I just needed to talk to somebody, really, you know. I can't speak to Jesse, and Jimmy's off somewhere.
He seems like a nice man, Jimmy. Full of life.
Oh, is that all right?
Oh, that's Mum and... Mum and Dad.
She's still a looker, wasn't she, eh? And he was a decent bloke, if I remember. Well, he must have been to take you on.
What was it you wanted to talk about?
Well, it was what you said about not keeping in touch. I mean, like just now, passing me off as a friend of Sylvia's.
Oh, come on. Think about it. If I'd introduce you as granddad, so who does she think that is? So say I get her through all that, and then what if you walk away again? What if you turn your back on us?
You know, when I was at my mum's, I had loads of time to think about stuff, you know.
Oh?
Yeah. Stuff about me and the kids and this place. And work. I mean, I'm dead happy with you and the kids, obviously, of course. It's just... I need a bit more.
Well, what was it you said before? 12 minutes? I think I can manage a bit more.
No, I need to be more than a sex object. Or just mum. I mean, I love the kids more than anything. But I think I'd be a better mother if I could get out and do my own thing. Max, I need to go back to work.
I'm amazed at how long you've stuck it out, actually.
Is it that obvious?
No, what is obvious, Mrs. Farnham, is that you made a decision and you were determined to stick to it.
So you didn't think I have, then?
Yeah, you have. I think you're going to enjoy this decision a lot more, though.
Well, listen, how do you feel about us getting a nanny or a childminder?
Yes. Been there, done it. That's not the issue, though. We've got to make sure we've got enough time for each other. We both know how each other's works can take over each other's lives. Especially when some people have got to do things like governor's meetings.
Oh, yeah? How did that go?
It was really great. Yeah, I enjoyed it a lot more than I thought I would.
So what were the other governors like? All lawyers and high flyers?
No, not all. Some professionals. Oh, and one friendly face, ex-surveyor, like me.
Oh, yeah? Who was that?
A lady called Gabby Thaxter. Yeah. She was a big help getting me into it all.
So what was she like?
She was really nice. All the time I was talking to her, I was thinking, have I met you somewhere? You know, those times when you're convinced that you've met before.
And had you?
But no, it was when I got back to the house I realised she reminded me of Patricia, you know. Same sense of humour, same smile. Yeah, she was a really nice lady.
Think you're going? Choir boy.
Queer boy.
Oh, please help!
at you yet.
Leave me alone!
Want a photograph?
Get yourself a lawyer, yeah? You're gonna need one. My solicitor says it could be scarred for life.
Get out me way, or you will be scarred for life.
Ooh, a threat. Must remember to tell that one to me, Brief. Beat me senseless, and now you're threatening me.
You and I both know this will never get to court.
I mean, you've got form, you've saved time, and there's 1,001 people around here who are itching to see the back of you.
You reckon?
I reckon. So why don't you do us all a favour, eh, and crawl off to whatever back street it was you came from. Give us all a break. It's me who's going to be having a break. A nice long holiday on some sunny beach, paid for with the money that I get out of you.
Yeah, I mean, the photos will swing that for you, won't they, eh? One look at them, your judge will be weeping buckets.
He will, yeah, when he sees them, reads the medical report and the security video. I'll have me not the palm of my hands.
I must have misheard you. Did you say security video?
That's right, yeah. The eye don't lie. What would you believe they call it?
Nice try, Leanne. But I've heard it's been wiped.
There isn't any.
Well, I can't bother. You see, Bev, I've got an ace up my sleeve. My star witness, Max Farnham. Local businessman, father, devoted husband.
Looked great in court, weren't he? Bit of posh, bit of a looker, reliable. Still, can't stand here gabbing all day, can I? Some of us have got work to be going to. See ya.
Do you know what? I can't believe Bev left that loser in charge. Saves her right of it, and that Christie have wrecked the place.
Yeah, well, they have. So much so that Bev came to me and asked me to order stock for her on my account. Well, I just advised her to sell up, you know? Just get what she can for it and get out.
Oh, how bad can it get, eh?
Well, a bit worse than that, I'm afraid. When Bev and Leanne had their little fight, there was only one witness, and Leanne's calling on him to give evidence in court.
Oh, yeah? Who was he? No. Max, you are joking. Well, there's no way you can give evidence for that bitch. I mean, remember, she nearly blinded me. If you say one word in support for her, I mean it. There's no way me, you, or that shit will be rolling around any of these carpets in future. Got it?
Got it.
Hello. Hello, Mrs. Plummer. Anthony? What's happened?
No chance of getting any kip round here, is there?
Shh. What do you mean there's been an incident? Is he hurt?
I'm on my way.
Look, when you were missing, I remember lying in bed, hoping that someone would knock and tell him that they found you and that you were all right. These jobs that you do.
Yeah, I do them for you.
I'm not sure I won't used to do them anymore.
Anything you want, I want there for you. You'll have your own place one day, you know. Hairdressers, nails, whatever you like. Might even get that place. Then you'd open up every morning, knowing that you owned everything in sight. And there'd be no one knocking at your door about bills, which your confinement demands at you. And you'd be proud of yourself, what you've done. You'd be proud of me.
I already am proud of you.
No, you deserve better. I'm gonna get it for you.
But at what cost, Tim? Losing you? Because if that's what it takes, I don't want it.
Oh, what's she like, eh? Oh, well, it's a thought that counts.
Much thought gone into damage, dear.
Oh, Mike, do you always have to be so ungrateful?
Well, what do you want me to do? Sit here tugging at me forelocks, grateful for the handouts?
All you do is sit and complain.
Well, is it any wonder? Do you know what, Jackie? I am the only one round here who doesn't seem to get a look in. If you need something doing, ask Jackie. If she's not available, ask Max.
Hey, don't be bringing Max into this.
Well, my dad's already done that, hasn't he? And you? Who was the first person you thought of to look after great grannies while you're away? Your brother? No. Do you know what that made me feel like, Jackie? Having my brother-in-law coming in here, telling him what he's done with my own father's money.
Hang on a minute. You weren't asked because you're not capable. Mike, you were caught robbing off me dad once before. You were caught with your hands in the till, you
remember? That is ancient history.
We're the ones who are running this house. We're the ones who are putting up with Ray and Jessie. We're the ones who are paying the bills.
Hey, do you know, before you go round shouting the odds, you want to get your own house in order?
And what's that supposed to mean?
Well, do you know, if you put half as much energy into getting yourself a decent job as you did moaning, you'd be quitting. I mean, look at you, mate. You're nearly 30 and you're still living with me, Dad.
And you certainly made the break, didn't you? You'll end up living next door to the house you grew up in with a fella who's old enough to be your dad.
That's cheap, mate. At least I've made my own opportunities.
Is that what you call it? Barry Grant certainly made you an offer you couldn't refuse. What exactly did you have to do to get your foot on the ladder, Jackie?
Well, do you know what? No wonder you're stuck here, sponging off me dad. Look at you, like the world owes you to living. And what have you done to deserve one, eh? Nothing. Yet, well, it's Rachel and Beth I feel sorry for. Because where are they going to be 10 years from now, eh? Still living here with me dad, while you sit there whinging about what a hard time you've had.
You're okay now.
I want to go home.
Okay, so, what did he do to you, mate?
Doesn't matter. I just want to go home.
You're with me now. You can't hurt yourself.
You can't help me.
I feel as though I'm living somebody else's life, you know. A couple of months back, everything was fine.
And then I came along.
Oh, no, no. You're the one thing that's keeping me going. I had a wife I loved, a home, and I thought I had a future. But as far as Jessie's concerned, all I've got is a past.
She's had a lot to get used to, Ray.
Oh, no, I admit that. She said she's learned a lot about me lately. Well, I've learned more than I want to about her.
You don't mean that.
Oh, I do. Do you know, I found out that while I was scratching around trying to get cash to put my mum into a decent nursing home, she had £20,000 worth of shares. My mum was living in a second-rate old folks' home, and she was earning interest by the hour. And she didn't tell me.
She must have had her reasons.
What reason could she have for making my mother's life more difficult? When was the last time you saw Sylvia?
Not too sure.
The last time I saw her was in the park at the top of her road. It's a boiling hot day. She'd been to the cinema. And I remember saying, fancy being stuck indoors, you know, on a nice day like this. But it was, it's a birthday treat, you see. She just bought an ice cream for the little girl she was with.
I dropped it by the swings.
And you cried your eyes out. I said, it's only an ice cream. I'll get you another one.
That was you.
I asked her to come away with me, you know. Go away together, start again. How could she say yes to me offering to run away with her? Take you? You didn't even know she was your mother. She said, imagine what it would do to little Ellen, having to leave the people she thought were her mum and dad.
I had no idea.
She was right, though, wasn't she? I mean, family's important. If you lost family, you've lost everything.
So if Sylvia were to walk in now and ask you to go with her, would you go?
That would depend very much on Sylvia. There's something else I wanted to tell you. Last week, my mum died. Your grandmother.
Oh, Ray, you should have said.
Well, I wanted to see how you and I got on, you know, before I told you, like, but, well, your family now. Your hair family as well. You have a right to know.
I'm sorry.
Well, I thought you should know. I'll get off home now.
You will not. You'll come and sit down and tell me all about her.
You don't mind?
Mind? I'd love it.
That last job that you did, that was the first time you've ever lied to me. I mean, I'll put up with most things, Tim, but when you start telling me lies...
Hey, I only lied because I didn't want you to worry. It won't happen again, eh?
I bet it hadn't.
Father told you where I was going. You'd have been worried sick.
If you'd have told me where you were going, I would have stopped you. You can only get away with it so many times. I mean, the river, Milan's fire, that business with Jimmy on that job. If they'd have caught you, they'd have put you away in no time.
Yeah, but they didn't.
Yeah, but you're looking on the old for so long. One day it's all going to come on top, and there'll be nothing that you can do. And what about the future, eh?
Oh, that's years off.
Now our future, our kids.
We can't even think about kids, yeah?
No, not now, but someday. And what can I offer them, eh? If you're in prison or even worse, if one of your jobs goes wrong and you end up dead. Because believe me, Tim, it can happen. It happened to me dad and Jason. One minute they were just there and the next they were gone.
Yeah, well, I won't let that happen.
You won't be able to stop it. And what will I do then?
So what is it you're asking, eh? You want me to get a job in some minty call centre, earning buttons for the rest of my life? You keep on going on about our future. If I end up in some crappy little job, we haven't got a future.
But we've got each other.
And how am I supposed to get a mortgage on the amount of money those places pay, eh? Or feed a kid? Or me and you, for that matter? I'm qualified to do nothing. It's the only thing I can do.
You haven't even tried.
I never stopped trying.
Well, you need to try harder then, because you're going to end up just like Jimmy. And if you think that I'm hanging around just getting by like Jackie Corkill did, then you've got another thing coming.
Nice one.
Tim, where are you going? Tim! Oh, sod off then.
There was lots of things I should have said to my mum, should have told her. But I never did.
I'm sure she would have known.
How could she have never told her? Mum's dying made me face up to things. It made me think. Well, you found me, we found each other. I know I can never make up for what happened all those years ago. But if I can't be a father, at least I'd like to try to be a friend.
Can I ask you a favour? I mean, if you say no, if you don't want me to, I completely understand. Would you mind very much if I came to the funeral tomorrow?
Yeah. I'd like that very much.
Here you go. Get that down, yeah?
I don't want it.
You like tomato soup?
Only when I'm sick.
Carrying on like nothing's happened.
It's been like that since I picked him up.
What did Mrs. Plummer say?
The usual.
Right, I'm off. Everything all right? See you later then, mate.
God forgive me, but I could quite easily kill them. They're not children, they're animals, they're monsters. Stripping them naked and leaving them lying on the floor, what pleasure could they possibly get from that?
I don't know.
The kids, what makes them do things like that? I've racked my brains trying to make sense of it all, but I don't care. They've hurt my son time after time after time. I'll tell you something else, they won't do it again.
So he's definitely not been to yours?
We're not joined at the hip, you know.
Well, yeah, no wonder Tim took off. The way you've been carrying on lately. Here he is now. He can play happy families again.
All right.
Yeah. He's off.
I'm just going to see if we can track Jimmy down.
Yeah, it's lucky he's still got a few mates left, isn't he?
I went up before.
Yeah, and you've given up. So don't be waiting up for us.
Late to meet you.
Yeah.
So, you back then?
I'm starting. Look, I'm sorry. You were right. If I carry on the way I am, it's just going to hit the fan, isn't it?
Tim, I want us to last. And it's not going to if you carry on lying to me.
I know. Hey, Steve's getting something going with his van. Might put something in the paper. You know, van driver, that sort of thing. Might make an honest man out to me, eh?
I think it's going to take a bit more than that.
Yeah, I'll be careful.
And I meant what it says about that money. It stays where it is until our Nicky needs it.
Yeah, all right. Do you love me again?
So, what are we going to do about Jimmy?
Well, we'll leave Nicky and Steve to the night shift. And I'll see what I can do in the morning. Until then, we've got a bit of making up to do, haven't we?
Mm-hmm.
about Helen? Maybe you ought to invite her.
I have done.
You never said.
What are you doing with this?
Well, it's only a card. She gave it to me.
But I don't want to do anything that's going to come between you and Jesse.
It's nothing to do with her.
Jimmy Corkill.
Jimmy? What's happened? Is he all right?
Find out tomorrow at 8 o'clock. Next tonight, a lady with 90 grand to spend and some very specific needs. We're in Nottingham for location, location, location.
To me, I was only walking to Newcastle, and there's no need for these. Yeah, I'll get them off.
Do you know how long you're gonna get for this, eh?
Walking
do you?
The Queen's Highway is a crime now, is it?
Assaulting the police officer, I'm talking about.
That's what it comes down to. Go for a walk and get yourself arrested, great.
You can't walk through the Mersey Tunnel, no.
Because the car is king.
Because you could have been killed, you fool.
All hail the mighty car! Down with the pedestrian! Hang them, flog them, jail them. Cut off the feet and make them take a taxi. Freaks that they are. All because they want to use the God-given legs they were born with.
Don't be giving me all this act, pal.
Wanting to get from A to B under their own steam.
I know what you're doing and it won't work.
History lesson. World's worst invention.
Nobody butts me in the nose and gets away with it.
The wheel!
It's not funny. I'm having you.
Oh.
You're going down for this.
Wait till I see that Mrs. Plummer tomorrow. She'll have to do something now.
Come back the power on for us again.
Now that she's seen him stood there dripping wet and the toilet floor soaked.
You shouldn't need evidence.
She says she can't expel them without a pile of evidence this high. Otherwise the governors will just reinstate them again.
That's a pile of crap and all. They do what she tells them to. Max Farnham's a governor now, isn't he?
So?
So I think I'll have a word to him and get him on our side.
Will that help?
I can't do any harm, can I?
Well, we shouldn't have to do all this ourselves. It should be the school. And what happened to the video cameras you were getting?
You can't put cameras in the boys' bogs. It'd cause murder.
There's one outside, though. And if they followed him in, I might just have picked that up.
How long do they keep the tapes for?
I'm going down there now. I'm not taking any chances. I'm going to get it and I'm going to stick it on the plumber's nose. She'll have all the evidence she needs.
Hang on. I'll give you the lift.
Right, you. I'm going to leave you in here for a bit till you calm down.
Get these off me.
If you've calmed down, when I get back, I'll think about it, OK?
Break the law by going for a walk and what do they do? Tie your arms together. Well, now, look. I can still walk.
I am walking. I am walking.
Shut up and sit down.
You'll have to break your legs first, because no one stops me walking, pal.
I'll be back in a minute. Keep an eye on him. What are you worried about? He's cuffed, isn't he?
Yep. All right. Yeah, I'll be over there soon. Bye.
Oh, do you know what? The harder way here than at my mum's.
Yeah, I've made you this.
Oh, brilliant. Hey, will you keep this up if I go back to work?
Oh, all right, then. As long as you agree to be here at some time.
Are you sure you don't want me chained to the kitchen sink?
Oh, well, I'm game if you are.
Oh, do you know what? It's not that I can't cope.
Yeah, I know that.
It's just I need more. A life outside of the home. I mean, you've started on the school governor's thing.
Jackie, I've said all along, whatever you decide to do, I'll go along with.
As long as we make sure that we always make time for each other.
Well, apart from a nanny, I was thinking of getting some extra help in the restaurant.
But what about asking Rachel, you know, about childminds?
Well, she might feel that we're patronising her.
No, not if I ask her, right? And I know I can trust her with them. You know, she has an auntie and she only lives next door. I'm not being patronising, just practical. And it's not going to be long before the kids start school, is it?
Scott of the Antarctica, Roald Amundsen, all rolled into one, that's me. A bipolar explorer.
Has he been like this the whole time?
Not your history, kidder.
OK, you win. I'm convinced. You didn't know what you were doing. So why don't we just start again, eh?
I always know what I'm doing. How do you mean?
Let's forget about the broken nose.
What are you saying?
That it never happened. So why don't you sit down?
Why don't you stand up?
Okay, sir, suit yourself. I'm Keith, by the way. That's Joe. Can you tell me your name?
I'm no grass.
I only want to know your name.
That's all you want to know?
Yeah.
Well, I want to know everything. Round and round Picton Library. Round and round the internet. Book after book after book. I want to know it all. Every bit of information. Suck it all into me head. And you? All you want to know is my name. You know what's sad?
What?
I'm not gonna tell you. Cause I'm not a grass.
Must think I was born yesterday. Talking to me about grass.
Go and check all the psychiatric units, see if anyone's missing. I'll see if I can find out who he is.
Oh, hey, are you sure your dad won't mind?
Well, you've got to lock the path for your old mum's funeral, haven't you?
Oh, thanks.
I've been thinking, Ray, I will come tomorrow.
Nah, don't be daft. I mean, you never knew her. And besides, you've done enough for us since the fire.
Yeah, but even so.
No, come on. You stay at home and get your sleep.
I'm going to boil that bacon joint tonight, so it'll be easy to cut in the morning. Now, do you think that'll be enough?
There's no need to make a big spread, you know. We don't want a lot of people coming back here disturbing Mike.
Oh, Ray, you just do what you've got to do. Don't worry about me, OK? Rachel, I'm going to work now.
Hi,
Ben and Jean are coming all the way from Southampton.
Yeah, I know. He's got to work the following morning, so they're going straight back after the funeral.
See ya.
What about Helen? Maybe you ought to invite her.
I have done.
You never said.
Yeah.
Didn't I?
I was going to take you away for your birthday next week. Night in a hotel, just the two of us.
Oh, that'd be lovely.
Well, it would have been. But we couldn't afford it. I had to cancel.
Yeah. You did the right thing, Mike. We can go away next year.
See you later.
See ya.
Are you married?
No, never.
Not the marrying type, eh?
Seeing someone, though. No names, no pack drill. Ever had sex on a pool table? In a pub?
No.
Me and Bev have.
How did you manage that?
After hours, everyone gone. Potted the pink.
Work in a pub, does she?
Work there, she owns it.
What's her name again? Bev...
I'm not a grass.
I think I know her.
You don't?
She runs JR's in town, doesn't she?
You're trying to trick me. I won't get away with it, though.
OK, forget Bev. Can you tell me where you live?
Anywhere I like. Do what I want. Free man me. Don't take orders. Don't take drugs. Pot the pink.
Why were you walking to Newcastle?
Can't fly.
It's a long way to walk.
Not for Chairman Mao. Know your history, kidder.
When we picked you up, you had no ID, no money, no bags on you.
Too heavy. Had to get rid of them.
And you were walking to Newcastle through the Mersey Tunnel. Know someone in Newcastle, do you?
Couple of people.
Who's that?
No one.
There must be someone. Friends, family.
These two people mean a lot to me. If I tell you who they are, don't send a cop car around to their house. Don't allow the busies knocking on the door in the middle of the night, yeah?
I promise you, we won't bother them. Just tell us their names.
Ant and Deck. Had you go in there, didn't I? Promise you, he says. Promise we won't bother them. As if! See that, Frankie? Running rings round them, I am!
Imagine if it was one of your two, Jack. You just feel so helpless.
Well, won't the school sort it out for you?
But that's the point. They've got this anti-bullying policy, but it's not worth the 22 pages of paper it's written on. That's why I'm here.
Well, as I say, I'm relatively new, but if there is anything I can do...
There is. Me and Di are going in to see Plummer tomorrow.
By then she should have seen the CCTV video evidence. And if Plummer comes back with her usual excuses, I swear to God I'm going to knock her out.
I know you're angry, but in those sort of meetings, it's better to keep calm.
We've got to go through the proper channels to satisfy the governess. That's what she keeps saying. Well, you're a governor and a neighbour. And all you've got to do is say you're satisfied. That we've got to get rid of them little cows for the good of the school.
I tell you what, I'll make some inquiries, see what I can do.
Thanks, Max.
I'm not promising anything, though. As I say, I am new, and there are other governors.
Just to have you on our side to help.
I'll let you know.
Thanks, Jack. Sorry to bother you.
Oh, that's OK. Yeah, it all works out for you.
Cheers. I'll get out of your way.
What are you talking about?
Be with you in a minute, sir.
OK. Rude to whisper. Professional opinion, nothing. Talking about me, I can tell. Right. You want to stop it now? Stop it!
Thanks, Doc.
Where's he going? What have you been saying? Talking about me?
Ring the hospital. Let them know we're coming. Yeah. Tell them to have some sedatives ready. I don't think he'll come without a fight. Sorry about that, sir.
Who was that?
Friend of mine.
Talking about me? I could tell. What was he saying?
I was asking his advice.
About what?
Whether you should stay here. He agrees with me. Time for you to go.
To Newcastle?
Yeah, that's right.
Fantastic.
Give you a lift if you like.
Oh, I'll walk.
Well, if we drive, you could be there in no time.
Fantastic.
Well, that's put me in a bit of an awkward position, isn't it?
Oh, what's awkward about it, Max? If little Anthony's getting bullied...
By girls?
Hey, there were some hard-case girls even at Brookie Camp when I was there.
Well, especially when you were there.
Mm.
That's not the point, though, is it? I mean, we haven't heard the school side of the story yet. And I'll give Gabby Thaxter a ring, see what she says. She's been at it longer than me.
What are you doing with this?
Well, it's only a card. She gave it to me.
Oh. So she's a property consultant now, is she? Is that the new posh way of saying estate agent?
Probably.
You know what this means, don't you?
What?
Take everything she says with a pinch of salt.
Gonna be great. Can't wait. Can't wait to see him.
Who? Ant and Deck?
Not the real names, you know, Ant and Deck.
Aren't they?
No. The girls!
That right.
My daughter and my granddaughter. I love them. They love me. It's going to be really great. Really great.
I think we're here.
Oh, fantastic. Hey, listen, lads. Thanks a lot. I really appreciate it. Really do.
Well, mind you, Daddy, see it?
Yeah. You lied to me! No! 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 You don't use something on me! No!
Calm down, sir. Everything's gonna be all right. These people will help you.
No drugs! No! No drugs!
Me and Jay are going on a demo in London next week.
What about?
It's a protest against student debt.
If you're so in debt, how can you afford to go all the way to London?
Because the NUS are subsidising the travel. So don't worry, Nan. Won't be coming out of any of your precious insurance.
You can say that again.
Oh, don't let's argue today.
I'm sorry, Ray.
Come in, Helen.
Thanks.
Let me take your coat.
Thanks for inviting me back.
You're family now.
Can I get you a drink, Helen?
A cup of tea would be nice.
Let me get it. Won't take a minute.
Is everything okay?
Yeah.
Good. I'm glad you came.
Yeah, me too. It was a lovely service.
Yeah. It must have been strange for you.
Yeah, it was. She was my grandmother, but I had no idea what she looked like. You haven't got a picture to show me.
No, I'm sorry, love.
All the way through the service, I kept thinking, I wonder what she looks like. I just couldn't picture her. And then I couldn't help thinking, I wonder what Sylvia looks like now. So I came to a decision. I want to find out.
Ray, I'm going to have to go now.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I've got loads of things to do.
Oh, thanks for coming,
love. No problem.
God bless, kid.
Okay, and nice to meet you, Helen.
You too, love. Take care of yourself.
So, you want to find Sylvia?
Yeah, but I don't want to do anything that's going to come between you and Jesse.
It's nothing to do with her.
Do you want to find her too?
You don't take sugar, do you, Helen?
We'll talk later.
No. Ta.
Hiya. What are you doing in here on your own?
Moping.
Things that bad?
Oh, couldn't get any worse.
Bev, you haven't seen Jimmy Corkle about, have you?
No, but if I did, I'd be hiding from him. Not the only one I owe back pay to, you know.
So there's no chance of getting that back?
Sorry, Nick. There's nothing I can do. Bar's finished. Leanne's suing me. I'm gonna be. Like I said before, things couldn't get any worse. Ah, but then again...
Do you think when you get the chance, I'll be able to get a reference off you?
Yeah, I'll do one now for you if you want to, if you get a pen and paper from the office.
Thanks, Bev.
Put the kettle on while you're there.
Are you Beth by any chance?
Is this something to do with Leanne Pearl?
No, it's about some fella we picked up last night. He's all right, like, we're just trying to find out who he is. Do you own this place?
For now.
I have reason to believe this fella might be your boyfriend.
I haven't got a boyfriend.
The next, maybe.
Well, there's a few of them. Gotta be more specific.
Well, this might not be true, like. That's all I've got to go on. He said he had sex with you. On a pool table. Ring any bells?
Jimmy Corkill.
Jimmy?
Let that be a lesson to you, Nick. Things always can get worse.
What's happened? Is he all right?
Hey, Steve. You know this tuning gear you're always going on about? What if I bought it for you?
What?
Me and you. We could go into partnership.
Are you joking?
No. O'Leary and Murray. Mobile mechanics.
You're not a mechanic.
No, you be the mechanic. I'll be the mobile bit.
What's got into you all of a sudden?
Emily's been going on at me to... find some proper job. I mean, after everything what's happened, I'm just getting a bit worried.
She's not the only one. After that little fiasco with Jimmy, I'm expecting a knock at the door any minute. I've got involved in my last scam, I tell you that for nothing.
Yeah, I know. I feel a bit last on you, to be honest. I mean, you only did it because I told you that you'd end up with enough to start your own business.
Man, I won't fall for that one again.
So if we club together, maybe we could have enough. So what do you reckon, eh? Me and you, partners?
Nah.
Why not?
Because I'd have to do all the work and you'd take half the profits.
What? Hello? All right, Nick. What's happening?
The busy's off. Where? Well, is he all right?
The busy's found Jimmy.
Has he told him anything?
Shh. Which hospital? Yeah, we'll give you a lift down there. Where are you now? Okay, we'll be there in 5 minutes. Bye.
Sorry to keep you both. Oh, hello again. Marty. Right. Let's make a start, shall we?
Thank you.
There's plenty of food and drink in the kitchen if you'd like to stay.
Oh, no, I'm okay. Only Pop John's give you that. But, you know, if there's anything we can do...
Thanks.
I'll show you out. Thanks, Rach. Hey, listen, can I have a word?
What about?
Well, I've decided to go back to work.
Oh, good for you.
Thanks. Only the thing is, I need a child of mine, so I was wondering if you're interested.
Hiya.
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 It's not entirely conclusive.
Why does it suddenly go dark?
Because they threw something over the camera.
You saw the state of them. And you saw the state of the toilets afterwards. And I filled in an incident sheet.
I know, I read it.
You've got incident sheets up to your eyeballs. You've had them on conduct reports, target sheets. You've had them in isolation. You've had the educational welfare officer in. You've done reintegration. You've had them in front of the disciplinary panel.
And nothing's worked. Our son's still being bullied.
So now we want some proper action.
And we're not leaving till we get it.
There's no need for anyone to lose the temper here. We're all on the same side.
Prove it!
Tell us what you're gonna do!
And we want more than fancy words this time.
I'm going to exclude them for 3 days.
3 days isn't enough!
Will you let me finish? I'll give them a 3-day exclusion. And in the meantime, I'm going to call a special meeting of the Governor's Disciplinary Panel, at which I'm going to recommend they both be excluded permanently.
And will they listen to your recommendation?
I've never known them not to.
About time.
Just because you can decide to go back to work don't mean it's as easy for everyone else.
I know that.
Mike's tried to find better jobs.
Oh, Rach, I didn't come here to talk about Army. We're talking about you. I paid a good wage.
Well, I've already half promised Bev that I'll help out with Josh.
Yeah, but Josh will be at school most of the day. And once Bev sells the bar, she probably won't be hanging around here anyway.
I'll think about it.
And let me know as soon as possible if you can. I'm desperate to get started again.
OK.
Thanks, Rach. See you later.
See ya.
What did she want?
She's going back to work.
Oh, surprise, surprise.
She wants me to look after Harry and Emma for her.
How does she know? Well, I don't think so.
The police found him, walking to Newcastle.
Did he tell them anything, do you know?
Wouldn't even tell them his name.
Well, how did he track you down, then?
He just said where he worked.
Oh, so he has told them something?
He's never come off his tablets, I warned him. If you'd phone the doctor straight away.
Hey, I didn't know what was going on. Just did what he told me to do.
He didn't know what was going on either. Poor sod. You'll miss her, won't you?
Oh, I wish you could have met her, Helen. I should have introduced you when I had the chance.
We've all got regrets, Ray. Things we should have done. But it's too late now to worry about them. All we can do is learn from them.
I did love her, you know. In my own way, like.
Of course you did. You should try and find your mum before it's too late.
Well, to be honest, I have been thinking about it.
Well, it's the natural next step, isn't it, after finding Ray?
Yeah.
We could help you look for her, if you want.
It's about that offer you made me before.
Oh, have you decided?
Yep, I'm gonna do it.
That was a quick decision.
Yeah, well, it wasn't a hard decision. We need the money.
Oh, Rach, that's brilliant. I'm made up. Hey, Rach is gonna look after Harry and Emma when I go back to work.
Oh, thanks, Rachel.
But, can I have an advance on my wages? It's my birthday next week and me and Mike were thinking of going away for a night.
Yeah, that's fine. Hey, does Mike know about all this?
I haven't told him yet, so don't mention anything to him.
Well, there's no point hanging around here. I'm getting off. You coming?
Follow you down, Bev. How come she's here? I mean, how come the busy's went to her? She got something going with him.
It's none of your business.
Never again. You're not dragging me into anything like this ever again, all right?
I turn over and you leave myself.
What do you do?
Seems as though you're not interested in a partnership. I might get my own van. Do a few legit jobs. Cash and like.
Oh, yeah, very legit.
Yeah, well, at least they'll get Em off me back. Do you reckon that mate of yours will be able to get me a cheap van?
Look, I've told you. From now on, I don't do anything dodgy. If you want a van, you'll have to get it legally.
No, I don't mean that. I mean, you'd be better than I would be.
True.
How much would it cost?
Well, you should be able to get a good one for about 3 or 4 grand.
I haven't got that sort of tank.
Have to start saving up then, won't you?
I know a girl who does. Em stash is going to give to Nicky.
Do you want to lose your knackers?
Well, if she wants me to go all above board, she's going to have to make a sacrifice too. Even if it is a sister.
Don't look at me as some sort of...
Why? Because you are, eh? No! Will you listen?
Well, I was, in the neighbourhood.
I'm sorry, Rach, but this is typical Jackie. She plays a beer mum for 5 minutes and then dumps her two on us.
I had a right to defend myself.
What have you done, Jimmy?
Brookside returns tomorrow at 8:30. You can find out more about manic depression and have the chance to ask confidential questions by checking channel4.com/help.
Right. Right. Any more news on Jimmy?
No. Me and Emma are going to go to the Aussie, see how he is.
Do you reckon he said anything to the busies?
No. If he had, he would well be in on the bounce by now.
Yeah, but what if they're biding the time, waiting to see what else he says?
I don't know what you're sweating for.
Oh, and you're not?
No. Look, Steve, what kind of state do you reckon he was in when they picked him up, eh? And even if he has said anything to the busies about us knocking that fella's gear off, I'm not likely to believe him, are they?
Maybe not.
I don't have a word of him when we go in. Try and find out exactly what he said.
All this aggro waiting for what? A couple of Easter eggs and some lippy?
Tell me about it. You still have to sort me out with that van?
If you like.
Oh, yeah.
There's no options today, actually, but you'd need the money up front.
No props?
Yeah, if you can sort air.
When I can sort air?
Well, after that, just have to hope Jimmy doesn't drop us in it. Well, the only van we'll be seeing is the one taking us to Cove.
Want me to walk you around?
Nah, I'll be fine on my own.
Not quite as scary now Melda's been excluded.
She'll be back though, won't she?
Yeah, and she'll be too worried about getting expelled to pay you any mind.
You think?
I know. Listen, Anthony, the school are on your side. They know what's been going on. That's why they've excluded her in the first place. If she even looks at you the wrong way, her feet won't touch the ground. Now, have you packed your sports kit?
Yeah, it's 40 today.
You don't like that much, do you?
Well, because I'm not that good at it. They always pick me last and stick me in goal. It's freezing being stuck in goal.
Do you want me to pack you an extra vest?
Oh, you couldn't give us a note, could you? Like, something wrong with my foot or something.
I thought this was your big chance to get things back to normal, put what's been going on behind you.
It is.
You don't want to be left on the sidelines.
Well, can't I have the plans without the specification? Oh, all right then. Well, as soon as you can. Bye-bye.
Should I come back later?
No, it's all right. I was just trying to pin down the architect.
Having work done at the restaurant?
No, here, the house. We're having it extended, Simon back.
Rather you than me.
So, what did you want to see me about?
Oh, I brought you the minutes of the last governor's meeting.
Oh, thanks. Well, there was no bother, you know. I could have easily emailed them.
Well, I was in the neighbourhood, so...
Oh, well, there's quite a bit of light reading here, then.
Well, in case you nodded off first time round.
Would you, coffee?
Ah, thought you'd never ask.
Actually, you know, I was going to call you.
Oh, yeah? What for? Nice.
Oh, thanks, yeah. Well, I wanted a bit of advice. It's a bit embarrassing, really. I've been approached by Anthony Murray's father. It's a bit awkward, really.
Oh, is this about the recent development?
I don't...
Oh, I thought you would have heard with you being a neighbour.
Heard what?
Imelda Clough's now on the fast track to exclusion. She had another go at him, apparently.
Is Anthony all right?
Luckily, yes. Can't say how Chairman George will view it all in relation to our league table performance, though.
Still can't tolerate antisocial behaviour.
Oh, good Lord, no. All we're doing is passing the problem on to another school. Which is exactly how we ended up with a little terror like Imelda in the first place.
Not as if she's had enough chances already.
It's down to the parents, if you ask me.
He's always been a bit pompous, hasn't he, old George?
Aren't we all? But most of us don't make a career out of it.
True, true. And what about you? Why are you on the school governors?
Gets me out the house, exercises the grey matter, and I get to meet interesting people.
Oh, it stinks.
Hmm?
Oh, sorry. I forgot they were in there. How much is it?
The lot. $3,500. So don't go buy me a lemonade.
You've been keeping this lot in the house?
Hmm?
Weren't you worried about getting it robbed?
Very funny. You're not nervous about carrying it on your own, are you?
No, I'll be all right.
Good. I've got a lot riding on this.
Listen, this man in the van, Lark, it'll be hard graft, you know.
Yeah, well, that scares me a lot less than him bending me about staying straight.
What was that?
See? Nothing gets past there.
Just as well someone's looking out for you.
No, Steve, go on the auction, the savvy. He's going to sort me out with a van.
How much have you given?
The lot.
What? The full $3,500?
Hmm?
Well, what about Nicky?
I'm sorry, but how many times has she asked? She knocked me back. Said she didn't want me dirty money.
Yeah, don't blame it. It reeks.
Well, what if she changes her mind? Tim, I said to
her... How many times does she have to ask, eh? I said no, she's had a chance.
Has she now?
Yes, she has.
Not in my book, she
look,
hasn't.
If this is going to get the message.
No, you don't have to go anywhere, Steve.
Yet there is. Do you want? I need to talk to you.
Right, Rachel, I'm off to bed.
Before you go, there's something that I need to tell you.
Oh, I'm going to fall asleep standing up if I don't get me a done in the next 5 minutes.
Yeah, I know, but... Oh, well, I should have mentioned this earlier, really.
You're starting to worry me now, what is it?
Well, it's nothing bad, honest.
Well, come on then, just tell me what it is.
OK. I've agreed to look after Harry and Emma for Jackie.
Oh, today, you mean?
No, full-time. She's a bit stuck, you know, with her going back to work.
Rachel, I thought I said there's no way you're going to do that.
Yeah, I know, but I'm not going to let some stupid row get in the way of making a living. And Jackie's going to be paying me the going rate.
Oh, well, that's big of her.
Don't be like that. I think it's a really good idea. And Jackie knows that her two will be in good hands.
Yeah, which means she can get back to swanning about like Lady Muck.
Now, do you see why I didn't want to tell you? I knew you'd be like this.
I'm sorry, Rach, but this is typical Jackie. She plays a beer mum for 5 minutes, realises it's hard graft, and then dumps her two on us.
Don't be such a grump. She's been really good so far, and she gave me an advance.
How much?
2 weeks' money, which means that we can still go out for my birthday.
Which means that you'll be paying for it. What sort of a husband am I?
It doesn't matter who's paying. The main thing is that we enjoy ourselves.
And will Jackie look after Beth as well, will she?
No, but I can take her round there, so I'll be with her all day and be getting paid for it. Now go to bed.
OK.
Never mind, you and your mate and your stupid plans.
No.
She's my sister. Oh, she's got plans of her own, you know. My dad had plans for her.
Yeah, but...
So she's the only person in our family to ever go to college. And I'm not about to let you go and spoil it on some stupid idea.
Idea? It's not an idea, it's a plan.
What? Some minty old van that you're going to get off Flash Harry's, mate?
Flash Harry? Steve?
Oh, Tim, we said no. We agreed that money was for our Nicky.
Hey, what was that for?
Don't look at me as I'm some sort
of... Why? Because you are, eh? No, will you listen? I'm doing this because of what we said. Get something legit going which you could try and work at. Build something for the future.
Yeah, and I want to help Nicky.
Yeah, and you can. We can. Even more if we got some regular cash coming in. It's an investment, Em.
I know, but you said there's going to be no more lies.
Oh, I didn't lie. I just didn't have the chance to tell you. Do you have to do that?
What do you expect?
And do you really need me to tell you, eh?
Don't let me interrupt.
What's the matter?
To be fine as your man from uni.
Well, we offered you the money.
You don't know. And I told you where you can stick your dodgy cash.
Looks like you've just got yourself a van.
Shall I take the kettle on?
You might as well. Seems to have quietened down in here.
Has Sammy mentioned anything to you about finding a flat of her own?
Joking, aren't you? Take a ton of dynamite to shift off Sammy once she gets settled.
You couldn't have a word with her for me, could you?
I'll try, but I'm making no promises. It's Louise I'm worried about.
Why has she said anything about being unhappy? Problems at school? Anything like that?
No.
Well, what are you worried about then? You know, kids at that age, they're more resilient than you. Yeah, Gary now.
Do you think he knows we're here? I mean, he looks like a zombie.
Shh. He might be able to hear you. Get some change. Go and get us some coffees, eh?
Yeah.
Jimmy? Jimmy? Can you hear me?
Of course I can hear you. I'm not deaf. Sinbad was deaf. I'm not deaf. Or dumb.
I need to ask you something, Jimmy.
My uncle, he was deaf and all. They say it runs in families being deaf. Or is that something else? The busies. You know why they call them that, don't you? Because they're always busy, busy little bees. They are.
What have you said to them, Jimmy?
I was only going for a walk. King of the road, that was me. Walking along, bothering no one.
I need to know what you've told them.
This is a free country. That's what they say. Not for me. Not for Jimmy Corkill.
What have you said to them, Jimmy?
Is no man allowed to walk the Queen's highway anymore? The Queen, she's one and all. But they wouldn't stop her from walking. I had a right to defend myself.
Defend yourself? What have you done, Jimmy?
Can you
right?
Get up, Jamie?
Oh.
Yeah?
There you go. Now, Nurse Patrick's going to show you and your mum into our surgery. I can take a proper look at you. I think she's fine, really.
I think it was.
It was an epileptic fitness, probably.
What, I thought they were all over the place if they were having a fit.
Not always, no. I mean, sometimes they just lose consciousness for a few seconds. It looks a lot more dangerous than it actually is. The main risk would have been if she'd been on her own and banged her head and swallowed her tongue or something. Are you all right?
Yes, just took me by surprise, that's all.
Well, you look pretty calm to me.
That's a job, isn't it?
Yeah, well, it's the most important part. Always make the people think you know what you're doing. You're still on for this flat warming tonight, yeah?
Oh, I'm looking forward to a drink after that.
You hit one of the busies.
I had to. It was self-defense.
It's just brilliant, isn't it?
Don't worry, I never said anything to them. I'm no grass.
Oh, so how did they get hold of Bev, then, eh?
Well, all right, I might have said something about her. You know what it's like when you're having a bit of a gab. But I never mentioned your name.
Oh, sorry, I could only find one of them machines.
Mind the flaming coffees.
You need to bite my head off.
He belted one of the busies.
You what?
He told me just now.
Oh, he's probably making it up.
No, I don't think so.
Oh, so what if he did?
Look, have you been listening? If he's had to go with one of them, they're not going to let it drop. And they'll want to get him on everything they can. So V said anything about that robbery. We're knackered.
Kids, 10 more minutes and then we'll go see your Auntie Rachel.
There we are.
Do you hear me, Harry? Hey?
Right. Do you know, those children have seen more films than I have in my entire life.
Excuse me, don't knock it. It keeps them quiet.
Oh, by the way, did you ask Rachel to keep an eye on the children for a few hours tonight as well?
How come?
The new doctor's party. Oh, come on, don't tell me you've forgotten.
Who's been drinking loads of my mugs?
That was Gabby Thaxter. She popped round.
Oh, yeah, what did she want?
Oh, she just dropped off the minutes from the last governor's meeting.
Why did she bring them round here?
I don't know. She said she was in the area.
Oh, did she now? Still reminding you of Patricia?
Do you know, I make one tiny little comment and you'll never let me forget it.
I'm only teasing.
Well, I hope you are. There's only one woman I've got eyes for.
Hey, flattery will get you everywhere, Mr. Varner.
Really?
No, watch my lipstick. I've got a meeting in 10 minutes at the club.
Oh, yeah. How's it going?
Well, I wonder why I'm there half the time. I mean, I know Sol made a big mistake taking Sammy on, but... Well, he's got the place running like clockwork, I'll give him that.
Wish I had somebody like that at the restaurant.
Yeah, it is less stressful, but do you know what? It is boring.
Sounds like you need a fresh challenge.
Well, funnily enough, Rachel asked me if I'd thought about investing in Bev's bar.
That's a disaster, it's not even open.
Yeah, well, that's why Rachel suggested it.
Don't tell me you're even thinking about that.
Oh, no. They just give him a few more tablets.
Yeah, he was getting a bit excited. Rambling on without making much sense.
They said it's going to take him a few more days to come down.
Did he say anything else?
Like what?
All about the busies or anything?
Oh, yeah.
Well, what did they say?
I don't know if they're going to take it any further, but they had to charge him.
With what?
Something to do with him having a go at one of the busies, you know, when they picked him up.
Is that all?
Why all the interest?
No, it's just we're worried about him, aren't we, Tim?
I mean, the sooner he's back to his senses, the better, eh?
So, when do you think he's going to be able to come home?
As soon as he's stabilised.
Good. Get him out of this place, eh?
Yeah.
How was school?
Fine.
That good? What did you do?
Don't know. The usual. Double maths. Geography. Oh, I can't stand that, Mrs. Ramage.
She a geography teacher?
Yeah. She's horrible. She gobs at you when she shouts.
She wasn't shouting at you, I hope.
Oh, no. The lad next to me. She still gave me a shower, though.
How did games go?
Great.
I thought it was football.
Oh, it was. I got picked straight off. We battered that out a lot. 12-1 it was.
Well, I'm glad to see you're enjoying yourself. Much better now that Imelda's gone, isn't it?
Will you be really kicking her out for good when she gets back next week?
That's what the head says.
This place is depressing.
Voicemail again? Where is he?
Oh, calm down, will you? Ellen will be at that auction place.
Yeah, well, he better not have done a runner.
Steve Murray, I can hardly see it somehow. I mean, how far is 3.5 grand going to get him? It hardly pays for a flight to South America and plastic surgery, does it? Do you think this place is depressing?
I don't know. It just seems dead weird not having Jimmy around, doesn't it? It's that quiet.
I reckon, right, it could do with a big, massive makeover.
Do you reckon Jimmy will be okay?
Depends what you mean by okay. I mean, they should be able to get him stable in the Aussie, but he's going to have to stay on his drugs.
Do you reckon he could go mad again? I mean, because he was raving when we had him in that room, and then he went and had to go that busy.
Emily, you haven't got a clue what you're talking about. Jimmy would not hate a fly. He's probably more frightened than that busy, and that's why he lashed out.
Oh, Jimmy isn't the only one who needs to take a chill pill around here, if you'd ask me.
What's going on?
It's just some deal that he's got with Steve Murray.
Oh, the less I knew, the better.
No, it's nothing dodgy or nothing. This kitchen makes him there look minging.
Who's going to pay for this big makeover?
Me.
Right. Well, before you go splashing out, there's something I need to ask you. Max!
Hi.
Hi.
Oh, I believe you two...
Yeah.
Hiya, you're right.
We brought you this.
Oh,
thank you very much. Can I take your coats?
Oh, no.
Typical doctor. Always desperate to get your kit off.
Pay no attention. Over fertile imagination, that one.
Max, glad you could come.
Hi. Oh, this is Gabby Thaxter.
Ah, not tonight. Gabby Parr. Gary's my husband.
So, they're definitely going to kick you out.
Well, they didn't put it like that, but they weren't marking me work, wouldn't let me take any of my exams, so it's as good as.
Well, won't they give you a bit more time?
Bloody have. So, I was wondering if the offer of the £1,000 still stood.
Thought you didn't want any of our dirty money.
I know what I said, but I'm really getting desperate. I wouldn't be asking you otherwise.
No, no. I'm sorry if you're getting naughty.
It's all right, you've got every right to. There's me getting all high and mighty, and now I'm asking you for a favour. Please, can I have it?
Hey, I'd love to help you, and so would Tim, but
what?
This deal that Tim's doing with Steve, he's buying him a van so as he can stay legit.
Tim, legit?
He is. It's the gospel truth. You should have said earlier.
Didn't know how to. Especially after the way I'd knocked you back before.
I'm sorry, Nick. I'd really love to help you, and if I had it, I'd give it to you, but we're going to be living on everything that I bring in from the salon until Tim finds some more work.
It's okay, Em. I'll manage.
Are you sure? Nick, why don't you ring me mum? She wouldn't want you dropping out over money.
No, I've fleeced her already. Now, I got myself into this mess, and I'm just going to have to figure out a way to get myself out of it.
She doesn't look anything like Patricia.
I didn't say she looked like her. I said she reminded me of her,
but she's two different things.
Yeah, well, she's a lot younger for the start.
Gary was brilliant, though, wasn't he, Nish?
Oh, yeah, definitely.
What was that?
We're just talking about the little girl who had a fit in the surgery today.
Yeah, it turned out she had skipped her medication after all.
Is that why she has another fit?
Yeah. She'd been fine for 6 months, so Mum decided to stop giving it to her without talking to me first.
Did you tear a strip off her?
I think she got the message seeing her daughter like that, really. I just wish people would listen, you know?
I don't know what it is about this time of the year and people not taking the tablets.
We had another patient stop taking his lithium and ended up in casualty after a brief wander through the tunnel.
Still, there's not a lot you can do about it. People won't take your advice, is there?
The main thing nowadays is to make sure it's down on paper somewhere that you advise him in the first place. If anything had happened to her, you'd have been the one in the firing line.
You know, there's something not right when the paperwork's more important than the patients.
I should have told you what Gary did, but, well, I like to keep it quiet. I think people are afraid that he'll have told me all about him fiddling with their bits.
He doesn't, does he?
Not unless he's had a lot to drink.
I think she's one in the lot.
Oh, hiya. How are you? Fine.
Casey, I'm sorry I haven't been around more, but you know we're going back to work and everything.
I understand. You've got a life.
I should be mad busy getting the kids sorted, don't I? But you know, it's starting to calm down a bit now, so if you want to get together.
Oh, yeah, I would. I'll be having lunch tomorrow.
I'd love to, but I can't.
How come? What are you doing that's more important than seeing your Betty for the first time in ages?
Actually, I'm going to visit my dad.
Right.
I don't know.
Where have you been? I've been trying your mobile for ages.
Sorry, mate. Battery was low, so I switched it off. Didn't think I'd done one with your money, did you?
No, of course not.
So what do you reckon?
Yeah, son?
This, mate, was a bargain. Full MOT, taxed, clean as a whistle. Get it round the clock again as well, as long as you don't thrash it.
So, how much did it cost?
Well, there was a few dealers interested, so I was lucky to get it.
You had to use the full 3.5 grand, eh?
Oh, there's some left.
Oh, well in.
There you go. Oh.
Cheers.
excuse me. Do you mind if I have my husband back in 1 minute?
Sorry.
I have been monopolising him a bit. Yeah. excuse me, but you've hardly said 2 words to me all night.
I was just trying to be social.
With one person.
Well, we've got a lot in common. I didn't want to be stuck in the middle of doctors all night.
Oh, and I did. Yeah, well, I was watching if I was you.
Well, she's not like with everyone, I dare say.
Not from what I've seen.
Oh, she's just having a bit of fun, that's all.
Yeah, well, don't go getting any ideas, right? She might remind you of Patricia, but she's not going to be another Patricia.
There's only one woman I've got eyes for, and that's you.
But still, the building is attractive.
My dad's still at work?
No, he's down the harvester.
Have you had the row?
We don't have to have a row for him to go up the pub, you know.
How did our anchor on school?
Oh, he was buzzing when he came in. Got picked straight away for the football team at games. A couple of the lads even thanked him for getting rid of Imelda.
Where were they when he needed some backup, eh?
That doesn't matter now, he's through it. Reading between the lines, I don't think he was the only one who was relieved Imelda had been excluded. From what he said, she wasn't exactly Little Miss Popular with the other kids.
Then why they just didn't kick her out?
Well, that's what they're planning on.
Finally.
From what's been said, she'll come back for a few days while they work through the procedures. Then she'll be excluded permanently.
No more Imelda. Our aunt will be made up.
Hopefully this whole nightmare's finally over for us.
If Clough does anything...
Are we all right?
I'd love to see Leanne's nasty little plans fall flat.
I just wanted to say I was sorry about what happened.
But you do like working in Liverpool.
Tennis compensations. I don't want anything to come between us.
Bloody well know that, you condescending little cow!
Anthony fights back. Brookside returns Wednesday at 8. Stay with 4, because we're off to Craggy Island next.
There's your pair aren't up yet.
You're kidding.
No, afraid not. No, middle of the night, Harry gets a nosebleed, so we clean him up, settle him down, and then within an hour he's got a tummy upset.
Poor thing.
I know. Oh, I'm worn out.
I meant Harry.
Oh, well, he's us that need the sympathy, you know. Do you know, at 3:30 this morning, he climbs into our bed. He's like a chimp on speed. He was thrashing about all over the place, he was.
It's a bad thing to get into letting the kids sleep, yeah?
Aye. Well, you wait till Bet's a little bit older. Somehow they don't seem to be into child psychology at that time of night.
You look nice.
Will you go and see to him?
Yeah, sure.
And Max, will you wake Emma? Get it on the move. And Rach, I'm sorry that they're not ready.
Don't be daft. That's the whole point of me being here, isn't it?
Yeah, well, I keep telling her to drop the guilt trip.
So you looking forward to your first day back?
Well, I was, but things haven't gone that smoothly this morning. I don't know whether this is a good idea or not.
Oh, come on. You need something else outside the home. Most women do.
Do you know what? They'll feel rough.
Where's Harry's underwear?
At the end of the bed.
Trousers?
The same. They're at the end of his bed, ready for today.
Where?
Oh, hang on. I'll come and sort it out. You know what? You wouldn't think he lived here.
What do you call a man with leaves on his head?
I don't know.
Russell. Always makes me laugh, that one.
Doesn't take much, does it?
Yeah, you watch it, sunshine. You okay?
Well, everyone seems to think that I'm a little for the learn to lesson by the time she gets back today.
She will have some. I saw her when she was leaving the school with her mum. She knew she was in big trouble because she didn't expect the school to suspend her. Her face was a real picture.
Should have suspended it ages ago. Oh, yeah. Can I talk past me out on Tower's trip?
I didn't think you wanted to go.
Oh, that was only because my other Clough was going in there. I didn't fancy spending a day with her. One of the witches from the ghost train.
All right, listen, I'll meet you by the secretary's office at dinner time.
OK.
Listen, I don't know whether she will, but if Clough does anything...
I'll be all right.
I mean, anything.
See you later.
There you go, one jumper.
Ta, is Emma up?
Yeah, Max is just getting her washed.
Jack, have you thought any more about Bev's bag?
No, and don't bring it up either. Max is trying to put on a brave face, but, well, he's worried that once I go back to work, we won't get to see enough of each other.
It's a good investment, though, isn't it?
Oh, I could turn around, no bother, but...
What?
Well, it's like some mercy mission for Bev, isn't it? It gets her out of a big hole.
She's all right.
She's split me mum and dad's manager.
Well, I'm not defending her, but, well, don't people stray because there's something wrong with the marriage in the first place? And the bar didn't go under just because Bev was no good at running it. It's all Leanne's fault.
Well, she was a fool for leaving that cow in charge anyway.
Yeah.
Right, I'll see you later, mate.
Wish I had the money. I'd love to see Leanne's nasty little plans fall flat. Still, with a bit of luck, someone will come in and buy it and make themselves loads of money.
Well, won't be me. I'll see you later.
See ya.
Miss, can I speak to Anthony, please?
Yeah, go on.
Anthony, I just wanted to say I was sorry about what happened. And I won't do it again.
Oh, okay.
Thanks.
You okay?
Yeah. You never guess what Imelda just said to me then.
She started again?
No. She said... she was sorry.
Sorry?
Yeah, honest.
Yeah, well, it's a step forward, but... anyway, come on, see you next class.
Evan won't need you to take me home after school now, Dad.
Well, that's good, cos I've got a health and safety meeting.
I know I said I'd be there, but... I know it's important, but I can't get away that early. I want to be at a parents' evening, but...
have you got the number to that maintenance firm?
Lynn, I was at her last parents' evening on my own because you couldn't rearrange your schedules. So don't give me grief. Look, I'm doing what I can, but I can't do anything at the moment. Yeah. Bye.
Everything okay?
Oh, slight domestic. I'm needed at home.
Well, Jackie's here now. Couldn't she cover?
Yeah, I'm on a 6-month contract, remember? I don't want to make it look as if travelling back and forward to Leeds is a problem.
Well, are you extending your contract?
It's Jackie's decision, not mine. Well, I'll see her next week, so fingers crossed.
Oh, I'd be made up if you stayed on.
You just don't want to be left working with you-know-who.
Oh, you're not kidding.
I thought I should check the memberships of people with kids.
Yeah, I'm doing something for Solar.
Yeah, I asked her to try and sort the multitude maintenance people.
Yeah, well, she can do that later. I want to check the memberships of people with young ones to see if they might want a crash.
Well, you're the boss.
Hold up, I'll come with you and get next month's road to sort it out.
Oh, I'll make you a coffee.
Yeah.
Hey. You okay?
Yeah. You want to be sorted?
For what?
My dad's visit.
Oh, yeah?
What?
Oh, Mike, I don't think I can make it. I'm up to my eyes here.
Oh, you've got staff, haven't you?
Yeah, but there's things that I need to sort out. And plus, you know what, I think I've got a cold or something coming on.
OK, so I'm the only one interested in going to see him, then?
Hold on a minute. I've just spent the past fortnight helping my mum out. You know, after she did her ankle, and I didn't see you rushing down there. Oh, well, look. As they get older, I'm going to be doing more and more for them. I'm going to have to share that. Not score points off one another, because you did this and I did that.
All right. But,
what?
Well, am I supposed to walk? Oh, come on, Jackie, we were supposed to go in your car.
Oh, yeah, well, what about my dad's car?
There's no petrol.
Oh, Mike, you didn't need to put a couple of quid in it.
My wife has just signed on as your childminder, hasn't she?
And I'm supposed to be taken away on a romantic birthday break to some poxy hotel for one night. So, no, I haven't got the money for petrol. You know what, before you ask, I don't want to get the bus either, because I've been working every flaming night, so that means I've got to get my head down at some point today, not spend it enjoying the delights of our crappy integrated transport system.
Oh, so you do remember some of the books you read at uni then?
Yeah. Look, I'm sorry.
No, I'm sorry. We are, just don't wreck it.
Keep your fingers crossed for me, eh?
You're not that bad a driver, are you?
No, I'm going to complain to me, our fella.
What about?
Well, I'm going to let him know he's got lodgers, and he might be there till Christmas.
Best of luck, then, eh?
See you later.
Ta-ra.
Cheryl.
Hello. Hiya. Oh, you've got your hands full.
You're not kidding.
Oh, they're great at that age, though, aren't they?
Any buys for the bar knocking the door down you?
Oh, I wish. Do you know what? I'm giving the place a once-over for someone else who's going to come and have a look and pretend they're interested. Flaming Leanne, I hate her.
Something will turn up, you'll see.
Rachel, I've got more bills than a flock of geese. I've got final notices for business charges. I've got disconnection fees for the lecky. Leave me fairy godmother.
I tried to get Jackie interested.
But she laughed her head off.
No.
Well, she can't be interested, though, can she? She must have been rubbing her hands, chuffed I was on my uppers.
Well, she never said no, and she never said yeah.
Why are you so keen to help all of a sudden?
I want my old job back. We need the money. And you're a friend. I think this could work out for us all. See ya. Come on.
Bye. Well, from the file, you should have done the annual check by now. I appreciate that, but like I said, if anyone injures themselves on it, we'll be coming after you, okay? Yeah, we're just going to call me back.
What's the boss doing?
Well, we thought you were the boss.
Until she reclaimed her empire, yeah.
She's counting how many kids we can get into the creche. She could be onto a good idea, actually. So, if your wife's not happy with you coming up and down the M62, why doesn't she move here?
My daughter's settled in school.
Kids, eh? What would we do without them? If they're anything like our Lou, they'd see a move as exciting. And we do have better footy teams here.
I hate football.
But you do like working in Liverpool.
Tell his compensations.
Which are?
Excuse. Hi. Brookside Place. Mr. Carrington.
Mr. Carrington. Don't want to end up in court then, eh?
You didn't think I meant all that sorry stuff, did you?
Take Scrooge if you're good if you start again. And don't think I won't tell, because I will.
Shut up, Otterboy. I don't care if they exclude me forever. And even if they do, I'll still make sure to get you, wherever you are.
To give you the big hug, son, but they'll think we're passing Charlie at H over.
Stay to you, Charlie at H.
Well, I can't call it cocaine and edible, can I? The lads would think I was square. Had your corking to be made up, wouldn't he, eh? Knowing I was full of prison slang.
Well, he's banged up himself at the moch.
Oh, aye. What's he done now?
No, he's not in prison. He's in the psyche ward.
How come?
Well, he went to all manic, and the busy's arrested him legging it down the Maisie Tunnel.
Well, there is a speed limit.
I know that, but it's serious. He's sedated and all that.
I don't wish him any harm if he's off his head, like, but I won't be losing any sleep over it.
Yeah. Listen, Dad.
No, listen, son, me first. I want to apologise to you.
What before?
For tearing the strip off you the last time you were in.
Oh, no, that's okay.
No, I was wrong. Look, you had an accident and you flooded the place. But at least you were honest with me. Safe from the hip, you gave me the truth, and I admire that. Because I tell you, in here, you don't know who to believe. Perhaps the place itself makes you a bit cynical. But listen, son, all I know now is that family is the main thing. You've got to be able to trust them. And that's why, when I went back to my cell after your last visit, I thought long and hard about it. And I was made up that he came out with the truth. And I'm sorry for kicking off. Look. Because everything is now out in the open, you know, honest. I don't want anything, and I mean anything, Michael, to come between us. Do you understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, sure, Pops.
Good. Right. What was it you wanted to say?
No, it was just all the gossip.
Oh, come on, then, let me hear it.
She's in the office working with Sol.
Oh, how's he taking to you coming back?
Well, he seems okay anyway. He hasn't got a choice.
Well, he may feel as if he's getting his nose pushed out.
Well, his contract's up for review soon, so if he feels like that...
A bit tired.
Oh, thanks, Max.
I just don't want you getting run down, that's all.
Oh, Max, I've only done half a day's work.
Well, if that's what it's going to do to you...
Do you know what? I just think about a bug, that's all.
Why don't you go home, see if you're getting run down?
Because I can do this job standing on my head. I'm just getting back into it.
Yeah, as long as you've got staff like Sol.
Yeah, I suppose it will help while I'm planning the crash.
Oh, the crash.
What's that supposed to mean?
I was just thinking that it might take a bit more organising than you think.
Oh, yeah, because planning permission's going to be a nightmare. Recruitment of staff, social services, health and safety, you know, builders and decorators.
Okay, I just said you looked a bit tired.
Oh, I'm sorry. I just feel...
Hey, you're forgetting one thing, though. Your staff, what if they want to use the crash? I mean, what'll come first, them or the customers? Where will the profit be in that?
See you later.
Mum end up with a limp?
Well, not unless they bleed a parrot on the shoulder.
Ah, Jackie's a good one, though. Going over there to look after her.
Yeah, well, I would have gone myself, only made work in that.
Yeah. You only get the one mum, eh, lad? Wives. You can have as many as you like.
You're not thinking of taking the plunge again, are you, Pops?
No. I made a right mess of things with Anthea one way and another.
No, she messed you up.
Maybe so, but... The nights are long and earsome. And the lads going about their wives and girlfriends and how much they miss them. And how many days they're going to spend in bed with them when they get out.
Are you getting jealous?
No. But I'll miss Anth. I miss her now. We never achieved our best together. But hey, you make sure that you and Rach reach those heights. You're still going away for a birthday?
Well, we're doing a night in a brilliant hotel. Four poster bed, the works. I mean, money's a bit tight, but...
Wish I could help more.
Oh, no, we're doing fine. It's like a rock when I need her. I mean, she misses the point at times, but... I do love her, you know.
That's what I mean, you see, son. Family and friends. Tell you, when I get out of here, I want to get to know people more. Rach, Maxie, and Ray and Jesse. I want to get to know them two better. Burns out of their home. It's terrible.
I know, yeah, you can still smell it.
I want to help them.
Dad,
where have the poor Blighters ended up living now?
They're somewhere close by.
Good on them. 2 weeks, Michael. 2 weeks, then I'm out of this place. And off on a new road to discovery. Tell you, me family and friends were going to be closer than they could ever imagine.
These classes myself.
Good idea to keep toned up.
Especially if you're going on a beach holiday this year.
Oh, I think my beach holiday days are over for some time to come.
You can get last-minute bargains.
Not with Louise's school fees to pay, I can't.
I won't buy you any something for your birthday, then.
Can we take these down?
Why? We'll have them knocking the doors down.
No, it's not the idea. It's a sign itself.
A bit Bev's bar.
Looks okay. I thought it was pretty...
Well, why don't we cut it down and laminate it a bit more tasteful, right?
Yeah.
Fine. I'll just pop across to the garage and get myself a tasteful sandwich. Anyone want one?
No, thanks.
No, Tom, I'm watching me figure.
It's worth watching.
You two seem to get on very well.
We do.
He's married, you know?
Yeah, I don't know. That's why I haven't asked him to marry me.
Oh, sorry, yeah, I forgot. You're still getting over that sham of a non-marriage to Richard, aren't you?
Yeah. Look, can't we just forget about what went on between us?
You do your job well, things should be just fine.
Oh, hi.
Oh, I was,
Can I help you?
Jackie, I was wondering if,
She's at the desk.
It was just Rachel was saying, look, can we go somewhere else?
Oh, do you want me to disappear?
No, you stay in reception. I'll tell you what, I'm going to head up home soon, so I'll pop in and we'll go past.
Oh, great. Put the kettle on. Still manage that. Oh, sorry.
No problem. Quite enjoyed it, actually. Seemed like I said, again.
Isn't she back in charge?
Past caring. She might not extend my contract, so just be my pleasant self. Don't want a knack on my CV.
Wish I was that cool.
It's a front. I put my heart and soul into keeping this place going for her. Next week I might be out on me here. I'm not used to this.
So, would a drink after work help?
Brilliant.
Ruined it, haven't they?
Well, I wasn't that impressed with what you did with it.
I gave it a go. What's up?
It's cracked. A bit like me for even being here. This was my first jump into the pub and club business, you know.
Yeah, and when the time came, you were eager enough to get rid of it.
I was in a hole.
And I helped you climb out of it.
Well, it was a house of love, and you got a bargain.
Suited us both.
So, come on, what's the proposition?
You know the proposition. Rachel said that
you... Do you know what? I don't know whether I can be bothered.
So why have you come round here, then? Just to rub me nose in it?
Well, have you had the business values?
Yeah.
Well, in that case, what do you want to give me to take it off you?
I mean, the site itself is worth an arm and a leg.
I know that, Bev. I got it going in the first place, remember?
Yeah, but things have moved on since then, haven't they? I mean, ask Max, it's all about
Bev,
location.
I don't need to ask Max if the place is worth anything. I know, it is run down.
And don't you think I don't bloody well know that, you condescend a little cow? Oh, look, Jackie, let's just stop the bitchy stuff, eh? Just be fair.
Look, you need bailing out, right? But, Bev, the place isn't worth much. So I can give you the job, but that is it.
What? Just a job? No money?
You'd be bringing in more money than you've got now.
Do I look like I've just walked onto the planet?
And do I look like I need the hassle?
See,
I knew I'd get you.
Just leave me alone.
Oh, just leave me alone. Give me your money.
No.
Give me your money. I'll have your trousers.
Just leave me.
Get your trousers off now.
No.
You better have, because then you can sit in that pond.
No.
You're going to do whatever I want you to. I hate you.
Leave me alone.
School, Dad.
Something happened?
No.
Oh, this is going to be one hell of a night.
No, no, not Beth.
Oh, I can handle it.
Brace yourself, Dixon.
You know, when your son are going to be tossed out onto the street,
you're sick and you're twisted.
I'm really sorry.
If you're affected by bullying, there's a Channel 4 recorded information line with support details on 0870 122 9944, and you can call it any time. You can also ask confidential questions on the address there, channel4.com/health.